What do you think people should know about the historical parts of this book?
In the beginning of this book, they mentioned Valley Forge. When it comes to Valley Forge, there are a few things people should know. The book mentions that the soldiers are held up at Valley Forge. That the book mentions that the Continental Army is held up at Valley Forge. What they don't mention is George Washington hired von Hintzbergen to help train the Continental Army. Von Hintzbergen changed the tide of the Revolutionary War because without him we would have lost the Revolutionary War.
Why is von Hintzbergen so important to history?
Von Hintzbergen is important to history because one of our basic freedoms is to be seen as individuals. And like so many people, von Hintzbergen was thrown out of the Prussian army for being gay. It was George Washington who saw the potential of von Hintzbergen, not because he was gay, but because of his skills.
What do you find inspiring about von Hintzbergen?
I'm bisexual. The history of von Hintzbergen and George Washington reminds me that as Americans, we are free to love who we love. In America, all that matters is how hard you work and not your identity.
How did the American Revolution start?
The Revolutionary War started because the American War started because the British imposed a lot of taxes, a series of taxes, and the colonists didn't like being taxed from all the way in England because they didn't feel represented by the British. It's important to remember that the Americans and the British had two separate cultures because they were so far away from one another. And John Locke compared the structure of good governments to the nuclear family in two treatises of government. There was the sugar tax, the stamp tax, and the tea tax. The slogan of the American Revolution was no taxation without representation, which is similar to the disability rights movement's slogan, there's nothing about us without us. This is why our country has a long history of fighting over taxes, which sets the stage of how we talk about taxes today and under what condition the taxes are owed.
What makes the tea tax the tax that started the war?
Our country has a long history of protesting various things. Some protests were successful and some were not. The protest that started this American tradition was the Boston Tea Party and the lesser-known New York Tea Party that Haym Solomon was involved in.
During the Boston and New York Tea Party, did anyone die when the Sons of Liberty went to the docks to throw the tea in the water?
Although it is true that some protests in our country turned violent, these protests were peaceful except for the Boston Tea Party. After the Boston Tea Party, a group of patriots decided to murder a group of British soldiers. This became known as the Boston Massacre. In the beginning of the story of Purim, there was a similar event to the Boston Massacre. where Mordechai goes to the castle, where Ahasuerus is beginning to plan an attack on the Jewish community. So in response, Mordechai goes to kill 500 Persian subjects who didn't do anything to the Jews at this point.
If the Revolutionary War did not start with the Boston Massacre, how did it start?
The Boston Massacre was not the start of the Revolutionary War. It was politically motivated and was an act of terror, not an act of war, making the Sons of Liberty distance themselves from the people who committed the Boston Massacre. It didn't become a war until the Declaration of Independence was signed, and George Washington was named general. The start of the war wasn't until the first shot was fired at the Battle of Lexington and Concord, which is famously known as the shot that was heard around the world.
Was anybody ever prosecuted for the Boston Massacre?
The individuals who committed the Boston Massacre were held responsible. And in court, their lawyer was John Adams. When John Adams was asked why he took the case, he said it was because everybody has the right to a fair trial. This is where the Sixth Amendment come from, where everybody has the right to a trial with a jury of their peers.
Where did Thomas Jefferson get the idea of having 12 jurors on a jury?
Before Thomas Jefferson wrote the Constitution, he spent a lot of time reading Jewish texts and legal and different legal perspectives. As the French philosopher Montesquieu said in The Spirit of Laws, where he points out that different cultures have different amounts of people serving on a jury, the beginning of this tradition starts with the Talmud and damages, where there were two jurors and two witnesses.
Who were the Sons of Liberty and what were they fighting for?
The Sons of Liberty were a group of patriots who wanted to separate from the British. The goals of the Sons of Liberty can be summed up by the words of Patrick Henry when he was giving a speech to the House of Burgesses in Virginia, where he said, "Give me liberty or give me death." Back then, there were two groups, British Loyalists and Patriots. The US was the first country to be founded without a king. The British Loyalists identified as British, and after the war, they fled to Nova Scotia in Canada, which at that time was a British colony. One of the groups that was similar to the Sons of Liberty was the Underground Railroad, which was a network in the South helping slaves escape their captivity. The brave Southerners who helped the slaves escape through the Underground Railroad were killed if they were caught. Although the success of the Underground Railroad wasn't realized until the end of the Civil War, more black people were freed after the American Revolution on both sides. More black people were freed after the Revolutionary War on both sides as part of their condition for fighting for their respective side. Unlike in the Civil War, the slaves on both the American and the British side were set free as a part of their agreement to join the military. they got their freedom on both
Yes.
sides.
Yep.
What does it mean for you to be a first generation American?
I have become so attached to my American freedoms, I feel like I was born here. As a Russian immigrant, I love the movie An American Tale because Fievel's experiences were somewhat similar to mine because he immigrated as a kid. I liked the scenes of Russia at the beginning of the movie because it gave me an idea of what Russia might have been like. The movie made me grateful for being an American. Our country has always been a melting pot of different cultures. Where are you from, Dylan?
My family comes from Russia and Germany, and the movie that I always identified with was Fiddler on the Roof. Unlike Margot, who is from Russia, in order to understand where I am from, we need to understand that my family immigrated at a different time, meaning that my family's story is very different. I am from the Pale of Settlements, like Tevye the Milkman. The Pale of Settlements was a series of villages that segregated Jewish people under the Russian Tsar. It stretched from Russia to Poland to Ukraine. My family experienced pogroms where Russian secret police harassed Jews in the Pale of Settlements.
Why were Jewish people so attracted to the Declaration of Independence, and why did they want to fight for the Revolutionary War?
The reason why Jewish people were interested in the Revolutionary War is because throughout Jewish history, Jewish people have lived in places where they weren't free to practice Judaism, and oftentimes were killed for their beliefs. The Declaration of Independence served as a promise to the Jewish people that in America we would be free to practice Judaism. So Jews had a lot to gain from the Revolutionary War.
What makes the Declaration of Independence so important?
The Declaration of Independence raised the standard of freedom in the world. The Declaration of Independence was the first document that gave people freedom that they don't know they had. When Thomas Jefferson was writing the Declaration of Independence, he took inspiration from the Mishnah Torah, written by Maimonides, also known as Rambam, where he said, "We are all inspired by the universe with unique and equal talents."
What impact did the revolution have on the rest of the world?
It's important to remember that this was the age of revolutions, and the first was the American Revolution, and the next was the French Revolution, where Thomas Jefferson consulted on the writing of the French Revolution's document, The Rights of Man and Citizen.
How were the French and American revolutions different?
There were a few key differences between the American and French revolutions. The Rights of Man and Citizen outlawed slavery.
What was the American influence on French culture?
The Rights of Man and Citizen outlawed slavery, but the Declaration of Independence did not outlaw slavery and decided to leave the institution of slavery intact as a compromise to southern colonies for 10 years.
What was the American influence on French culture?
In a lot of countries where they are influenced by other cultures, the government is similar. This is why the French have a president like America does. And this is why Israel has a prime minister like England does, because Israel is based off of the British system that was put into place during the British Mandate after World War I. Culturally, the influence that the Americans had on the French can be summed up by the Statue of Liberty, which was a gift from the French to show their gratitude for help during the French Revolution.
And what influence did the Age of Revolutions have on religious freedom?
Perhaps the crown jewel of religious freedom is the establishment of Israel. If Thomas Jefferson didn't write the Declaration of Independence, the establishment of the State of Israel would have never have happened. The Declaration of Independence influenced religious minorities to assert their autonomy. It started in France, where a person in the French army, Alfred Dreyfus, was put to death just for being Jewish. Theodore Herzl, who was an Austrian journalist based in France, was changed by this forever. This became known as the Dreyfus Affair.
What was the biggest takeaway from the Dreyfus Affair for religious freedom?
Theodore Herzl knew that if the Jews were not safe in France, that Jewish people wouldn't be safe anywhere. This is why Theodore Herzl started the modern Zionist movement to establish the modern state of Israel, where Jews could govern themselves based on religious freedom. This is the legacy of the American Revolution and the formation of the State of Israel.
How did Haym Solomon's knowledge of languages help the Continental Army?
Haym Solomon's knowledge of languages helped the Continental Army because he could speak to many different kinds of people. He spoke to people on their own terms. For instance, Haym Solomon's knowledge of German helped him communicate with the Hessians, a lot of whom were German Jews. Haym convinced the Hessians to desert the British Army.
And how did Haym Solomon's knowledge of German influence his practice of Judaism?
Yiddish is a mixture of German and Hebrew that is used by Eastern European Jews. Haym Solomon would know Yiddish growing up being of Eastern European Jewish descent. It's important to bear in mind that Yiddish and Hebrew are not the only Jewish languages. The two languages that people think of most when it comes to Jewish languages other than Hebrew is Yiddish and Ladino. Ladino is a mixture of Hebrew and Spanish used by Sephardic Jewish people.
Did anyone else in the American Revolution speak Yiddish?
Yes, Jonas Phillips. When we think of using lesser known languages for military intelligence, we normally think of the code talkers of World War II, particularly the Navajo tribe who used their language so that way the Axis powers did not understand what the Allies were planning during World War II. Jonas Phillips used his language for intelligence because the British didn't know Yiddish.
Whatever happened to the Yiddish language, do people still speak Yiddish today?
Unfortunately, the amount of people speaking Yiddish is dwindling, other than ultra-Orthodox communities, because Jews in Europe were murdered, particularly in Poland, where Haym Solomon was from, where the Nazis murdered Jews during World War II by literally burning them to death simply because they were Jewish.
Were all the Jews that were murdered Eastern European Jews?
Although it is true that most of the Jews murdered in the Holocaust were Eastern European Jews, not all of them were. The Greek Jewish community was decimated during World War II by the Nazis, who were Sephardic and they spoke Ladino.
Did you lose family in the Holocaust?
Yes, I have lost family in the Holocaust. My grandfather said when Hitler rose to power, nobody wanted to be his friend because he was Jewish. On the night of Broken Glass, when the Nazis destroyed Jewish businesses, my grandfather lost his business.
Does Israel use Yiddish for military purposes, like in the Revolutionary War and World War II?
Israel does not use Yiddish for military purposes. Hebrew was mainly used for religious, for Jewish ritual practice, praying, and studying Torah until Israel ben Yehuda wrote the first modern Hebrew dictionary, which is the Hebrew spoken today in the modern state of Israel. When Israel was being founded, there was a revival of modern Hebrew, which is still being used today. Yiddish was frowned upon because of a desire to bring back Hebrew and unite Jewish communities from all over the world under the Hebrew language, because not all Jews are European. Margot, have you studied any other languages?
Da, ya govoru paruski. Yes, I learned Russian and I learned some Spanish for my job. Dylan, have you studied any other languages?
Ani ken yodat Ivrit? Yes, I understand Hebrew. I've studied Biblical Hebrew and I picked up some modern Hebrew studying in Israel for 5 months. I can read Hebrew despite my dyslexia.
Why was Haym Solomon a good businessman?
Haym Solomon observed trade in the shipping industry in New York, like Alexander Hamilton did. The business practices of Haym Solomon were clearly inspired by Adam Smith. As Adam Smith says in The Wealth of Nations, when countries have a good handle on trade, it puts countries in a better position, such as raising money for war efforts like Haym Solomon did.
How did Haym Solomon's business practices influence his Jewish practices?
Religious freedom comes at a price. For Haym Solomon, this could not have been more clear. On Yom Kippur, when George Washington came in to Haym Solomon's synagogue to get money for the revolution, to get money for the American Revolution, Haym was wearing his tallis. George Washington opened up a letter for Haym Solomon so he wouldn't have to work on Yom Kippur. When Haym Solomon received this news, George Washington was careful to cover his head in the synagogue. George Washington asked Haym Solomon to raise money for the war effort. It was the true meaning of bekuf nefesh. Haym Solomon's ability to raise money for George Washington on Yom Kippur was bekuf nefesh. Because of the letter that he received, and because bekuf nefesh lets us break Jewish law to save human lives. And this action saved our country for generations to come, which is the highest form of bekuf nefesh.
Does this happen a lot where, in order to ensure religious freedoms, that people put themselves in danger?
Throughout Jewish history, Jews have had to practice their religion in less than ideal circumstances. This is true when Jews were exiled from Jerusalem to the mountains outside Jerusalem, where they had to practice Judaism in secret to hide from the Greeks in the mountains above Jerusalem, which we commemorate on Hanukkah. When Jewish people were in concentration camps, they still had Jewish weddings and Passover seders, even though it made them more likely to be sent to the gas chambers. When Anne Frank was in hiding, she still celebrated Hanukkah from the attic. In the Battle of the Bulge during World War II, Jewish people got together with people dying on both sides to commemorate, to have a Rosh Hashanah service to commemorate the start of the new year.
What is the role of disability in protecting religious freedom?
Disability is a part of life, and the role of religious freedom is to empower disabled people to develop their own religious beliefs and spiritual needs, and to protect people with no religion at all. Disability can get in the way of them trying to express themselves religiously. This is why the right to religious freedom can't happen without discussing disability.
What should a disabled person do if the disability makes it harder for the person to express themselves religiously?
If a disabled person is having trouble expressing themselves religiously, they should ask for accommodations for the way they interact with the world and the way the world interacts with them. The interaction between George Washington and Haym Solomon is a great example of accommodations. Haym Solomon was not allowed to work on Yom Kippur, but a non-Jew like George Washington was not affected by these lo is not affected by these laws.
So he can open the letter for Haim.
So he can open the letter for Haym.
So what happens if a disabled person is denied accommodations?
If a disabled person is denied accommodations, this is illegal in America because you have First Amendment rights under the Constitution, the freedom of religion. Whoever is denied accommodations for their disability is going against the Americans with Disabilities Act, which gives us the right to accommodations in religious settings and all other parts of life. And in the Declaration of Independence, you have the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. From conception to natural death, whether you are disabled or not.
Does every country have the same protections we do under the Americans with Disabilities Act?
Great way to learn to be grateful to your country is to spend time outside of America so you can learn how exceptional America really is.
What have you learned from traveling outside of the USA?
I spent 5 months studying Torah in Israel. When you go to other countries, even the most basic things will be taken for granted when you come from America. In Israel, I stayed in an apartment without heat and nearly froze to death. I didn't even have a refrigerator. Has the Americans with Disabilities Act helped you express yourself religiously?
I have cerebral palsy and use crutches and a motorized scooter. The Americans with Disabilities Act means that I have the right to have a ramp to get into religious services. Dylan, how has the Americans with Disabilities Act helped you express yourself religiously?
Under the Americans with Disabilities Act, I can access audiobooks, which help me pray as a dyslexic person.
How did being in Israel influence your views on religious freedom?
When I was in Israel, I learned the true meaning of religious freedom because I had trouble expressing myself religiously. Because certain communities had issues with my sexuality leaning to tensions. One of the most important things about religious freedom is that people have the right to religious freedom even if it doesn't fit with every aspect of your life. This is why I made peace with the ultra-Orthodox when I was staying in Sfat for a month, because what matters is not my sexuality, but who I am as a person. The ultra-Orthodox should be judged on their character, not whether they approve of my relationships. This is why somebody who wears tzitzit and a yarmulke, as somebody who is bisexual, was so hard.
That's not What is a yarmulke and what are tzitzit?
Different communities handle the issue of a yarmulke, which is a Yiddish term for head covering, and for a Jewish head covering for men, or a kippah, head covering in Hebrew, differently. It is mostly worn by men, but in some communities, women wear them as well. The reason for me wearing a yarmulke all the time is because of the Shulchan Aruch by Rabbi Joseph Caro, who I studied when I was in Sfat, Israel. Rabbi Joseph Caro was in Sfat when he wrote the Shulchan Aruch, which is the standard of Orthodox Jewish law. The Shulchan Aruch, it says that a Jewish man should not walk more than 4 cubic feet because his actions are always being watched, which should inspire him to act in accordance with the laws of Derech Eretz, the Jewish laws for politeness. The reason why I wear tzitzit is to remind me of all 613 laws in the Torah, so that way I remember what the laws are.
How has your understanding of the Americans with Disabilities Act changed since returning from Israel?
My understanding of the Americans with Disabilities Act has changed because it's very hard to see the importance of these laws when you're living, until you have to live without them. In Israel, I was thrown out of a yeshiva just for being disabled. And there are steps everywhere, especially at synagogues.
When this yeshiva threw you out, what did you do?
When the yeshiva threw me out, I started studying 7 hours a day by myself with a screen reader because I believe religious freedom is at the utmost importance for the disabled. Even though I almost died 4 times as I traveled around Israel, as an American, I know that personal responsibility and self-education is what this country was built on. And I became more of an American patriot in Israel.
How has your commitment to Judaism changed since you were in Israel?
As a Jew, my commitment to the teachings of the Jewish people cannot be stronger. This is why I want to pursue rabbinical school. This is why I want to pursue rabbinical school, because I believe that disability deserves equality in the Jewish civilization. My time in Israel has shown me that by being a rabbi, I can help disabled people achieve their religious freedom.
Would you do the trip to Israel like that again?
Yes, it was a small sacrifice for my people.
Sophia.